Hey folks, I'm here with my friend David Dorward, who is the United Conservative candidate in Edmonton Gold Bar. Dave, it's so great to have you on the team. Great
Thanks,
to have
Jason.
You here. And
thanks very much.
So we're just having a chat about what to, first of all, to introduce yourself to your constituents. Tell us a bit about your background, where you grew up, and your professional background and everything else.
Well, thank you. And I grew up in Avonmore, which is in Gold Bar. So I've lived in that area for a long time. We've lived in Capilano for over 30 years, raised our family there. I'm pleased to have been able to be blessed with four children who have four marriages, and we have 17 grandchildren.
Oh, I thought it was 16. It keeps
growing. No, it was 17 just recently.
Congrats.
I'm a chartered accountant, Jason, with a strong tax background. I served the people in Gold Bar, thankfully, between 2012 and 15, in the government as
you
the
were a
MLA.
Minister, right, as well? Or?
Yeah, I was the Associate Minister of Aboriginal Relations.
Well, that's so an interesting and it must be fascinating challenge.
It was. You know, I learned a tremendous amount about our Aboriginal peoples, Indigenous peoples, and it was a thrill to be able to work with them for that period of time.
Good for you. So you've since sold your accounting firm.
Yeah, the young guys took over there. They allow me to have a desk there.
That's kind of them. David, you've been so deeply involved in the community in many different ways. I mean, just tell us, scouts and a whole lot of other things.
Yeah, you know, as a scout leader for 16 years, I coached basketball for 12 years in our area. And I thought in 2010 that we needed more facilities. So I went about raising $37 million and built a building in at the University of Alberta campus called the Saville Community Sports Center. And so thousands of youth get to play in there. And that speaks to my love of people and, having my heart turned to the people in terms of service.
Good for you. Dave, what has kind of compelled you to come back into to seek public elected office at this time?
Well, the joy of service. And having the ability to be able to use the talents and abilities that I have to continue to help people, whether that's in my constituency office or looking at the books and records of the province of Alberta, something that's mm-hmm. going to need to be done as soon as there's a change of government next May. The experience that I've had there allows me to be able to lead some of those processes and have, some input into that. I served as deputy whip, I was on treasury board, I was in public accounts, and so I have those experiences which are going to be valuable when the time comes.
At both public and private sector experience, that is invaluable. Last question, Dave. You've been knocking on thousands of doors, meeting with people for well over a year. What are you hearing from them? What are their top concerns or anxieties right now?
Well, the first two always come out is the carbon tax and the debt. Beyond that, we have an older constituency, and so seniors housing is something that always comes forward. Mm-hmm. And then people are concerned about the whole situation with safety in our communities and drug use being more prevalent. The people in our constituency of Gold Bar are affected by that through their children and their grandchildren.
Right.
And so they're seeing that and they want some action in that regard.
Well, thank you so much for this conversation, but more importantly, for putting yourself forward. I know how hard you've been working, and we're going to be with you all the way to Election Day, hopefully as a member of a United Conservative government. Then we're going to turn this economy back around to and renew that Alberta advantage. So thank you so much.
It'd be a pleasure to serve.
Thanks, Dave. Cheers.
Thank you.